Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, this is BestInSlot with some update news for Jurassic World Evolution. I know, mind-blowing. We got some little tidbits of information just yesterday on the Frontier forums. I'm going to read out that little statement now, and then we're going to talk about it, we're going to speculate about it a little bit. This is kind of unplanned. And, oh, they're inside each other, that's nice. And, I'll try to keep this relatively short and sweet, because we don't really have that much information yet. So, the topic, update news, question mark. We know there are a number of players within the community who are really looking forward to hearing what's coming next for the game being Jurassic World Evolution. And we haven't given any information yet as we want to ensure what we've got is 100% accurate. All we can say for now is that the team is working hard on future Jurassic World Evolution updates. We've got a small update planned in April, with more exciting things to follow later in the year. Now, this whole notion of not wanting to reveal any information, not wanting to do a roadmap and stuff like that is something that Frontier have pushed really hard lately on like the Reddit and stuff like that. P. Crowther, Paul, one of the community guys, has been saying it a lot. It, basically, the idea being we don't want to commit to timescales for DLC in case the DLC changes, in case we change what we're going to do, in case the quality's not there and we have to, you know, delay it, blah, 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 blah. It feels like setting timescales creates an expectation that maybe hampers game development, which is absolutely something I agree with. I, however, also feel that the fact that we know there's a small update coming in April, we'll talk about that in a second. We know, you know, a month, that's a big range. Even if they said April or June, I think people would have taken it. Wait, don't you say March, April, May? April or May, people would have taken that. We don't need specific directions, we don't need specific time frames, we don't even need to know what it is. I think all people want to know is roughly, really roughly, when we could expect something to happen, even optimistically. And I hope that is at least a sign they're moving even vaguely in that direction, because I do think, look, it's, I mean, that's their opinion on how they're going to handle it, and they know better than I do. I do think it's slightly the wrong way to go about it, personally. I think they need to be a little bit more open without necessarily giving us a roadmap and stuff like that, but that's just my opinion. I think there is a middle ground which needs to be found, and it's not there quite yet. But anyways, small update then, coming in April, and something else later on. We'll talk about both of those. So the small update, I really wouldn't expect much. It is a small update. Now, the word update does, however, imply that it is not a piece of DLC. It does imply it's going to be a free update. I don't really know what that would be. Maybe we're talking skin packs. Maybe we're talking a handful of dinosaurs, you know? We could be talking 2, 3, 4 dinosaurs. Maybe they're going to give us some dinosaurs. Maybe it's like last time, where what we're going to get is a DLC pack along with a free update. And if we are going to get a DLC pack, I would expect a dinosaur pack. I wouldn't expect anything groundbreaking, you know, it's a small update, it's not going to be anything huge for the game. So I'd expect maybe a dinosaur pack and then some small improvements to, say, sandbox mode or some of the animations. I wouldn't even expect bug fixes. We are looking for new content, even if it's only a smattering of new content. So that's something to get excited about. And it's worth noting that today is the 1st of March, and when Frontier posts their stream schedule for the month, they tend to have a stream listed as a developer stream. When you see a developer stream, that means there's an update coming. And now, I don't want to guarantee that 100%, but that has always been the case. Every single time, that has been the case. The developer streams are used to highlight upcoming DLC, upcoming updates, or updates that have just released, or DLC that's just released. Every single time without fail so far. So, when we see the stream schedule, if that pops up, we'll come back and we'll talk about that, and we'll definitely do a thing about that when it announces and blah, 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 blah. So, I wouldn't expect much from April, but they've said that they're working on more content for the game. Now, we kind of already knew this because we actually have, if we go into the SteamDB and look at Jurassic World Evolution, we can see what DLC is being worked on for this game, and we can see that there are two separate pieces of DLC or updates being developed for Jurassic World Evolution, right? We know there's at least two that have been in active development for at least a little while. So, I think the assumption is one of these will be the April update, whatever that will be, and then one of these is going to be a more substantial pack that we may get down the line. It's also worth noting, I don't want to get anyone's hopes up here, you know, for one, this DLC is probably a while away. I'd imagine we're talking May, June, July, probably June, July at the earliest, if I had to guess, given the updates in April. I don't want to get anyone's hopes up at all, I really don't, but they have mentioned, Frontier, how they are aware that terrain tools and stuff like that, like more advanced terrain tools or like more variety of terrain tools and decorations and stuff, is very much something people want. They are aware of that. You know, it's by far the biggest thing people have requested in the Discord, I'm sure, and the Reddit even, and I'm sure it is on the forums, I'm sure it's being mentioned everywhere, and there's no way they aren't seeing that feedback. I think they will know that's the thing people want more than anything, and what's the best way to make people buy your DLC? Give people what they want. Now, whether stuff like that is limited entirely to DLC, if that would be a good thing or not, that's a whole other kettle of fish I don't want to get into until we get some announcements. It definitely shouldn't be. It should be an update because it's something that should have been in the base game anyway. But hey, maybe we'll get that. Maybe, again, we'll have a big DLC like we did with Dr. Wu and a free update to go along with it. So we'll get a big piece of story content, which is what I would expect, and then a free update that adds terrain and a bit of decoration and stuff like that. That would be ideal. That would absolutely save the game for so many people. A game that I admittedly still adore, but that the player base is just not active on at the moment. It's really not. It's a shame, but it's true. I don't want to go on for too much longer. This is not going to be one of those ones where I try to drag it out to 10 minutes, unfortunately, for my wallet. But yeah, I'm really excited. I'd love some speculation from you guys at home. What do you want to see? The small April update is the one I'm kind of curious about. It could be a handful of free dinosaurs, but I don't know what it would be tying in with. It could be a skin pack update. We've never really seen that before. And I think they also know that the Velociraptor skins in particular are a bit of an issue within the community. Maybe that's something they want to address. That would be cool. I'm trying to think of other areas of the game that I feel are sorely lacking beyond bug fixes and stuff like that and like AI updates, and there isn't that... Spinosaurus, why are you dying? There isn't that much, I think, that needs changing at the base game. They've done a very, very good job at making the base game much better than it was. They really have. It's now about the other... It's about the train tools and decorations in order to bring that base game completely up to scratch. So I'd love to know what you guys think that's going to be, because the April update is something I can't quite pin my finger on. A small update. Hopefully we get a developer stream this month and we can find out for sure, but until then, thank you for joining me. Get excited, maybe. You know, we've got a couple of months to wait. Maybe, I mean, it could be 5 weeks or so until the next update then, in that case. And then something bigger later in the year, I think, is almost a guarantee at this point in time. No, it is a guarantee. We know they're working on content for the game. There's just maybe a little bit more time between updates than people would like, and people get a little angsty. Myself included, don't get me wrong. You know, I wish there was a little bit more open communication and slightly quicker updates. I do, but yeah, it's what it is. At least there's stuff on the way, right? That's something to look forward to. Thanks for joining me, ladies and gentlemen. I will, of course, keep you abreast. Great word. Not breast, but abreast. Abreast of all updates and stuff like that. If there is a developer stream, we'll definitely be talking about that as it happens. And hopefully I'll have some really exciting news to give you guys on this April update as soon as possible. Because, yeah, I think we all need it. Thanks for joining me. Cheers. Much love. If you did like this update, please hit the like button down below. Bloop, bloop. Cheers, much love as always. Bye-bye. A little shout out at the end. This video and others like it would not be possible at all without the support of you guys watching me at home, and also everyone on this Patreon page right here who supported me in the last month. If you want to help out as well, you can do so at patreon.com/bestinslot. Every little really helps. Cheers.